How do you explain to someone what it feels like to have such a tiny creature trust you to the extent that it will rest on your hand? That's inexplicable. Montana is a harsh place. Moving here from South Africa in winter, I really saw how extreme it can be. For the winter months, I didn't see much animal life. But as winter turned to spring, life emerged. Living in what sometimes feels like an endless sea of trees, I was amazed to see something as delicate as a hummingbird surviving in a place that can even snow in summer. I remember the first time encountering a hummingbird was on the back porch, and this colorful bumblebee flew past me. At least that's what I thought it was, because it was buzzing like a bumblebee might. And it was so small and fast that I couldn't really tell this was a bird. That was amazing to me. We had one hummingbird feeder somewhere in the house that you put nectar in. So I put it up. I hung it on a stand outside my bedroom window, and I started seeing these little things coming every day. Then I noticed all of the little personalities begin to emerge. When I had the different feeders around the place, I started to see how they interacted with each other, and that's really when the story began. The first hummingbird that I got to know was this bright orange and copper, the most beautifully colored rufous hummingbird. He sat on a fence post. From first light until just about dark. I never made out where he was going, although I think he may well have slept in the tree next to my bedroom window. But he would sit there all day, occasionally coming down for drinks, and then he would fight others who dared to come and drink at his little nectar feeder. At that stage, when the first male was around, the second rufous male hummingbird decided to make his territory on the other side of the yard where the other nectar feeder was. And that's when I discovered something really interesting. To attack their competition. They wouldn't fly in because flying makes a buzzing sound and that would alert their competition to them coming in. But instead, they would float in. It was amazing to me to see that they are self-aware enough to be quiet when chasing away their competition. We had some snow in early June, and I was fascinated to watch this rufous hummingbird take cover under the eaves of the roof. And he would sit on anything to take cover from the rain and snow. On the edge of the porch, on the bicycle leaning up against the porch. And that's when I really got to get very close to him. Because if I sat still enough, he would come take cover with me. And in fact, I could almost say that he was taking cover from the snow, using me as a shield. I had to wait for these birds to learn to trust me. My love for them grew as these sorts of experiences just grew deeper. It's difficult to love something that doesn't love you back. The only way to win them over is with love. He turned out to be the perfect embodiment of what people say a rufous hummingbird should be. He was aggressive about his territory, and he fought everyone else off. And he hung around for a long time. Through rain and snow, he would be on his fence post all day. Later on, he left for some reason, and I don't know where he went. It was an early summer week when we got a few days of rain, and although there was not much activity at first, it then became very busy. But after that, they went somewhere and I'm not sure what happened. So he just disappeared. A lot of these hummingbirds seem to go somewhere. And there was a calm where nobody seemed to come to drink. But then after a few days, a female hummingbird came in and took over the territory where the first male hummingbird had left. And she was very aggressive. Interestingly, she was not a rufous hummingbird. And so, to me, That's such a variation in the usual theme, that the rufous hummingbirds are the aggressive ones that chase everyone else away. But she even chased the rufous variety away. She was very gutsy, she was spunky. And she sat on the same fence posts that he had sat on. But it was really amazing to me to see this little female perform the same role that the males had done. In nature, we typically see males being aggressive and fighting others over food. But in this case, the little lady of the feeder threw everyone off. As summer turned to autumn, I started seeing these birds less and less, until eventually, one day, they were just gone. I missed having them around. It was only inevitable that my summer with hummingbirds would come to an end. But the birds have their own journey to go on, as do I. They're crossing a continent and an ocean to be somewhere warm. I've got my journey to finish, and I hope we can reunite again in this garden next summer.